Good morning to all my YouTube viewers. In this video, I like to discuss about test paper 3 on physics. Those aspirants are appearing in this year, especially JEE mains and NEET aspirants. For them, these test papers, and already we have released 50 videos, and this 700 problems has been already released. Go through each and every problem, that will help you to achieve any competitive target. And don't neglect any problem. All problems are important. It becomes popular when it comes. We don't know which one is coming. So all problems are important. Let us start today's activity. The quantity within bracket small n Planck constant divided by 2 pi charge magnetic field whole to the power half, where n is a positive integer, h is a Planck constant, q is a charge, and b is a magnetic field, has the dimension of. We have to find out dimension. We know n is dimensionless, h is a angular momentum, and q and b, 2 pi has no dimension, q and b you can replace by r equal to mv by qb, you can replace mv by r. I mean in this way you can solve. Angular momentum ml square t to the power minus 1, that is known to us. ML square t to the power minus 1, and QB we can replace momentum divided by the radius. I mean M t to the power minus 1. Substitute here and you will get length. I mean length will be the centimeter or meter, length will be the answer. In terms of length, you can see here area, length, speed, acceleration, length will be answered for this. Next job, 2. The cylindrical tube of spray pump has a cross section of 8 cm square, one end of which has 40 fine holes, each of area 10 to the power minus 8 meters square. If the liquid flows inside the tube with a speed of 0.15 meter per minute, the speed with which the liquid is ejected through the holes is, that means we have to find out eject out velocity of liquid molecules. Now see, by using equation of continuity we can solve this problem. Now here we know A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. For ideal situation, there is no viscosity of the liquid, there is no resistance, any kind of resistance in the passage. So here A1 is given 8 cm square. I mean it will be 8 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square, and velocity is given 0.15 meter per minute, that means 0.15 divided by 60 meter per second. And A2, area 2, the exit point, that is 40 holes are there, 40 into each hole carries a area 10 to the power minus 8 meter square. So total will be 40 into 10 to the power minus 8 meter square. Now for V2 we can write A1 V1 by A2, substitute, and we can get 5 meter per second. After simplification we will get 5 meter per second from here, you can see. answer B is the correct choice here. 5 meters per second. Now next job, the ratio of the rotational kinetic energy of the total kinetic energy of 1 mole of a gas of rigid diatomic molecules is, for rigid diatomic molecules degrees of freedom we can that will be 5 total degrees of freedom for this diatomic will be 5, 3 translational and 2 will be rotational. And we know from equipartition energy that each degrees of freedom will contain half into RT amount of energy. So total energy will be 5 times half RT, that means 5 by 2 RT. And translational 3 by 2 RT, and rotation will be 2 into 1 half RT. Simplifying, we require rotational energy divided by total energy. So RT divided by 5 by 2 RT will give 2 by 5. That means B will be the answer for this question. You can see here. Now question number 4. In a meter bridge experiment, null point is obtained at 20 centimeters from one end of the wire when resistance X is balanced against another resistance Y. If one decides to balance a resistance of 4x against Y, then where will be new position of the null point from the same end? It is a meter bridge. Total length is 100 cm. Now from that balance point, we can write X by Y. The first condition which is given, X will be 20 centimeters from one end, and we'll get 20 centimeters, X by Y will be 20 centimeters divided by 100 minus 20. That means 20 by 80, that means 1 by 4 will be the relation. Now the, for unknown 4X, we have to say at a length X, L it will balance. So taking a ratio of these two, 4x by y equal to L divided by 100 minus L, and already known to us X by y is 1 by 4. Simplifying, we will get L equal, twice L equal to 100, L will be 50 centimeter. That balance point will be 50 centimeter from the same end. A will be the answer for this. Now job number 5. A uniform disk of radius capital R lies in XY plane with its center at origin. Its moment of inertia about the axis, that is X equal to twice R and Y equal to 0, coordinate is given, is equal to the moment of inertia about the axis Y equal to D, where Z equal to 0. What is D equal to? We have to find out distance D when it will rotate with respect to X axis. D has to calculate. Now, 4 choices are there. We can do this job. This is a standard job. Now, here, moment of inertia of a disk. You see, here it is given uniform disk. Moment of inertia for a disk is how much? Half mr square. For, with respect to its diameter, suppose we have to find out at this position, that is 2r0, I mean here with respect to this axis. Now for this axis, first we have to find out with respect to this diameter, that is how much? Half of moment of inertia with respect to central axis, when z, with respect to z axis when it rotates because perpendicular axis theorem, we know Ixx plus Iyy equal to Izz. Here Ixx equal to Iyy, that's why we can say 2 Ixx or 2 Iyy equal to Izz. Izz will be half mr square. By integration you can derive this. From here then I will be half of mr square, that is this one, half of mr square. That means it is under, it will rotate with respect to y axis, because the coordinate on x axis, that means it will rotate with respect to y axis here, with respect to this x, if it is shifted with respect to this axis, that is 1/4 mr square. Now we have to shift this momentum inertia to here. That means you have to add whatever distance is there in m into distance square. That means mr square by 4 plus m, distance is twice r whole square, will give the moment of inertia with respect to these axes, that is y double dash and y triple dash with respect to this. Now sum up, you will get this type of expression. Then you have to equalize with the moment of inertia with respect to this axis. I mean, now it will parallel to x axis, some distance d from this, and that means this line is with respect to this line, you have to find out. Say, then moment of inertia for this, if you say mass is concentrated here, it will be m distance square. That will be m into distance square, this one. M into distance square. M into distance square will be equal to this one. Just like radius of gyration, mass into distance square. Then you have to find out that d. D will come root under 17 by 2. After simplification, you will get root under 17 by 2 r. That will be from here at a distance, this one, so root under 17 by 2 into r will give the equal amount of moment of inertia when it will rotate with respect to these axes. Now come to job number 6. An inductance coil is connected to an AC source through a 60 ohm resistance in series. The source voltage, voltage across the coil and voltage across the resistance are found to be 33 volt, 27 volt and 12 volt respectively. Therefore, the resistance of the coil is, resistance, coil has got its own resistance, that we have to find out. Is external resistance is being connected, that is 60 ohm. In addition to this, coil has got own resistance, that is to be that we have to find out. Now all the data are given, that is voltage of the source, voltage drop across the coil, voltage drop across the resistor. From this resistor drop, we can find out. First, we can draw a diagram, circuit diagram like this, where L is there, and this one is, this resistance is resistance of the L, and this is external resistance 60 ohm. Drop is 12 volt. From here, we can get current. 12 divided by 60 will give 0.2 ampere current through this AC supply. Now drop here is given, that is 27 volt. That means we can write V square here, that is V dash square, we can write that is equal to VL square, drop here and drop across its resistance, V smaller square. This is not known. Now this one is known, that is 27 square, that is given. And VL square, we have to find, we require to find out all these. VL separately it is given, 27. This is source square. We can write? Now, this is one equation available from this data, that 27 volt. That is 27 square equal to VL square drop across the inductor itself plus drop in the internal resistance of the coil. That is V suffix R square. Then take the full circuit as a whole, then this drop is given here, that is 33, source supply is 33 square, that will be VL square plus whatever total resistance is there, VR smaller plus V capital R whole square. Now this is given in the problem, that is 27 square and source is 33, it should be 33 square, you can see here, it will be equal to 27 square plus this one is not known, 2 as it is a whole square, the bracket a square plus 2ab plus b square in this way. This one is given, V capital R is given 12 volt, this is also given 12. So simplifying here, we can find out V suffix R. That will come after simplification 9 volt. Once it is available, then we can, because current is known, I into R smaller, that means I is 0.2 already we know, and this one will give you 1 by 5, 5 and 45 will come. 45 ohm resistance, that is internal resistance of the coil, that is required to find out. That means answer will be B here, 45, you can see here, 45 ohm. Once again you can see this job, first find out potential, this drop is say VL dash. VL dash square equal to its own coil's potential drop plus resistance drop, because they are having, these two are having phase difference pi by 2. So automatically their equation will be like this. There cannot be 2ab part because the angle between them pi by 2. So that will cancel. Now for the entire circuit, resistance will club together and this one. That means VL square, VR plus VR, V smaller, V bigger whole square. Simplifying and substituting this one, we can get all data are available, only V smaller will be available from here, that is 9 volt. Thereafter, current is known 0.2, you have calculated from this data, 12 volt drop for resistance 60 that is given, therefore 0.2 is known to us. So substitute here and you will get your expected answer, that is 45 ohm. Now next job, a ball of mass 0.2 kg rests on a vertical post of height 5 meter. A bullet of mass 0.01 kg traveling with a velocity v meter per second in a horizontal direction hits the center of the ball. After the collision, the ball and the bullet travel independently. The ball hits the ground at a distance of 20 meter and the bullet at 100 meter from the foot of the post. The initial velocity of v of the bullet has to be found. Now, this is very important. This diagram is very important. The height is 5 meter and bullet is fired here. And ball will fall at a distance 20 meter away from the foot of the tower, and this one 100 meter away. From this we can get time from this distance, because it will come down due to acceleration, due to gravity. We can able to find out time required for each one, because this distance is known, horizontal distance. A vertical distance height is known. Time will be root under twice h by g. We can get the time. And height, as height is fixed, acceleration due to gravity is fixed, so time for both the ball and the bullet will be same. It will hit the ground at same time. Only horizontal range will be different for different object. Now let us see how we can start this job. First, we should use conservation of linear momentum. Whether it is perfectly elastic or partly elastic, whatever may be the collision, if there is no external force experienced in the system, you can use conservation of linear momentum. As it is horizontal plane, no gravity force won't react, won't play in the motion direction. So we can use conservation of linear momentum. Now, M1 is a mass of the ball, and U1 is initial velocity of the ball, plus M2 U2, mass of the bullet, velocity of the bullet, equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. Now initially ball was raised, so 0.2 kg into 0, and for the bullet 0.01 kg, velocity is V2, and thereafter these velocities are to known. Anyhow, 0.2 kg into V1 plus 0.01 kg into V2 is there. So we got one equation. Thereafter we know time of journey is same for both. 1 second, already know height is fixed here, this will give 1 second. Now from here we can find out velocity, because horizontal velocity is required, and V1 will be distance travel for the ball is known, that is 20 meter divided by 1 will give 20 meter per second is the velocity of the ball in the horizontal direction. Similarly for the bullet, 100 meter per second will come. Thereafter put it here, that is U2 is our objective. Put here, you will get 20 into 20, 400, and this is 100, total 500 will come. 500 meter per second will be the velocity of the bullet. Now you can see answer D is the correct answer for the job number 6, job number 7. Now come to job number 8, this one. An ideal gas is taken through the cycle, that is A to B, B to C, C to A. I mean, started A, return to A again. As shown in the figure, if the net heat supplied to the gas in the cycle is 5 joule, the work done by the gas in the process C to A. You have to find out work done during this C to A process. Let us see how we can start this job. Here we have to first identify that the velocity, volume is in y axis and pressure in x axis. Pressure unit in SI, volume unit also in SI, so no problem. Now we have to start from A. Let us see how we can do this job. Now we know that heat energy given to the system, say A to B is Q A to B. Then there will be, according to first law of thermodynamics, du A to B, work done A to B. Similarly for the second equation, B to C, that is du B C A to C, and for work done B to C, you see B to C volume is constant, so work done will be 0 here. Now come to third equation, that is C to A. dq c to a, that is du c to a plus dw c to a. Very simple approach, a to b, b to c, and then c to a. All the equations are available, three equations are available. Add all in the left side, you will get a to b, then c, then b back to a for all q if we add. Similarly du, a to b, b to c, then back to a. And similarly all the work done, this work done, this is 0, this is this work done. If we add, it will be look like this. A to b plus b work done due to c to a, b to c is 0, already have seen. Now in cyclic process, du for a to c is 0, and heat supplied in the sequence, supplied means it is plus 5 joules. If it is generated, it will be minus 5, but here it is plus 5 joules. And automatically this area we can find out PDB is the work done. You see, work done from A to B. Let us see. A to B. What has happened? Volume expand. How much volume has expand? 1 meter cube. What is the pressure? Pressure here is 10. The data is not written here. We see in the question paper. 10. Here. 10 Newton per meter square. So 10 into 1 will give the amount of work done here. Here. 10 into 1. Our interest is DWC2A. So keep this one in left side. And automatically you will see 5 minus 5 joule will come. That means you have to compress the gas and it will release energy. That is minus 5 joules. Amount of energy will be released by the system. Now come to next job. Young's double slit experiment is carried out by using green, red, blue color, one color at a time. Three colors light we will choose, one at a time. The fringe width recorded as beta G, beta R, beta blue respectively. Then we have to see which one is correct. This is a simple job, we understand. Wavelength for red light will be maximum. Then green light from VGOs you can find out. Violet is lowest among these 7 colors. And here it is, red is greater than green, and red is last. Then in between green, then blue. That means, as we know, fringe width is capital D by small d into lambda. What it means? Capital D means slit and screen distance, capital D. And what is small d? Small d, distance between the two sources, coherent sources, small d, very small. Now, from here, beta is directly proportional to lambda. That means beta for red will be maximum, then green, then blue. You have to see which choice is correct. D is correct. D is the correct choice here. Next comes to job number 10. A launching vehicle carrying an artificial satellite of mass small m is set for launch on the surface of the Earth of mass capital M and radius capital R. If the satellite is intended to move in a circular orbit of radius 7R, the minimum energy required to be spent by the launching vehicle on the satellite is, gravitational constant capital G is given. Job is like this, satellite and the launching vehicle both are on Earth surface. Thereafter, satellite will be launched by the launching vehicle just in the orbit where it will rotate around the Earth. That is the question. And we have to see how much minimum energy is required for this job. Now, as it is initially, it is on the surface of the Earth. So, what will happen? Total energy present on the stationary satellite and vehicle will be how much? Now, for satellite, we are interested in satellite minus GMM by R, only potential energy. If potential plus kinetic energy both is present, then that means minus GMM by twice R. In this case, it will be minus GMM by only radius of the Earth, because kinetic energy is not present. Then after launching the satellite in the orbit, what will happen? It will have potential energy as well as kinetic energy. Total potential energy required for the satellite to move in the circular path will be minus big M, then mass of satellite divided by twice effective distance. Effective distance is net now it is 7R, that means it will be 14R in the denominator. You can see in this way we can solve this problem. Initial energy is only minus gmm by r, and when it is this diagram is given, it has given a distance from center of the earth to this one is 7R, and here is the velocity say v. After simplifying we know that energy will be, final energy will be minus gmm by twice effective distance, I mean twice into 7R, I mean 14R will be here. Then what is the difference? Final minus minus initial. What happens? It will give us 13 by 14 capital G capital M small m. That is, that will be the minimum energy required to get the satellite into the orbit of the Earth. There, I think this will be the, this one, B is the answer here. Now, a man of 50 kg mass is standing in a gravity-free space at a height of 10 meters above the floor. He throws a stone of 0.5 kg mass downwards with a speed 2 meters per second. When the stone reaches the floor, the distance of the man above the floor will be. We have to find out at what height he will be at the end of the after throwing the ball. Now how to do this job? Gravity free zone, that means we can use conservation of linear momentum in the vertical plane. So by using conservation of linear momentum, we can find out velocity of the man and the ball which will come to ground, time taken for that, how much time it will take. It will reach on the ground, and that data will be available. All parameters are available here. Let us see how we have done this job. By using conservation of linear momentum, we'll start with this job like this. As no gravity is present, so we can use conservation linear momentum on the vertical plane. That is, a man mass into zero velocity initially, and a ball which is in his hand, that is also zero velocity. Thereafter he throws the ball, that means m into u will be the velocity of the man, plus m into v, and he has thrown the ball with a velocity, you can see here in the question. It is given 2 meter per second downwards. Both point is important. Now here we can see minus 1 by 50 will come. After simplifying this, you will see if minus point, after simplifying we can get velocity of the man, that will be minus 1 by 50 meter per second. That means velocity minus means man will go in the reverse direction, I mean upwards. Now time, how much time it will get, because h equal to, we know v into t, here no acceleration taking place, so ut s equal to vt or ut, whatever you say, that h will be 1 by 50 into time. That means time here it is available for 5 seconds, because 5 seconds is available, because the height was 10 meter, and it is coming down with a velocity 2 meter, so 5 second time is available for the ball. Similarly, it will be allowed to raise up to 5 seconds, so it will go 1 by 10 meter height, that means 0.1 meter. That initially he was standing at a 10 meter height, now further 0.01 meter will increase, so present height will be 10.1 meter from the floor. And answer we have to see here. here B will be the answer. Now come to next circuit job. In the circuit shown below, the switch S is closed at the moment t equal to 0. As a result, the voltage V across the capacitor will change with time t. Here you can see in this diagram that one charging arrangement has been made, one resistor parallel to the capacitor and another resistance is there. There is a source. Once switch is closed, a current will pass through R as well as C. After steady state, current cannot pass through this capacitor. It will be fully charged, only this route will be chosen. So we like to see when capacitor is fully charged. That means time required for the current, and after that will be how much? It will be 50 divided by twice R, and 50 divided by twice R will be the amount of current through this battery by this route, you can say. Capacitor not allowing any current thereafter. Now here it will be 100 divided by twice R. Now what will be the drop across this into R? That means 100 divided by 2, matlab 50 volt potential drop will be here across the capacitor. That means after full charge, it will have only 50 volt. Which diagram is going to satisfy this? It has started from 50 volt. No. Battery will, capacitor can charge maximum 0 to 50 volt. 0 to 100, coming down. Here is the possibility, 0 to 50 volt. And these drops are across the resistors, which is here. Now, C will be the answer for this. Now, next job, 13. In the figure shown that wedge of a mass Big M moves towards left with an acceleration A. All the surfaces are smooth. The acceleration of small m relative to the wedge is, we have to find out relative velocity of the small block m, small m. Angle 60 degrees given. Which force will help this wedge to move left side, and which force will be giving force to giving velocity to small m, that we have to identify. Now, this job we can do in this way. Normal reaction component will support this. Let us see. First, see this diagram. Now, this angle is theta. Now N normal reaction will be in perpendicular to the plane for this, and one of the component will be downward, that is N cos theta, and another component N sin theta. That means this wedge can travel, wedge can move due to this force only, N sin theta towards left side. And by this block also, same manner, we can see along this direction N sin theta is there, and along upward direction it is N cos theta, and downward is Mg. And Mg will be definitely greater than this one, and it is coming down also when it will slide this side. Actually, we are not interested about that side. We are interested horizontal. Now, we can write N sin theta for the small block. For the big block, N sin theta will be mass into acceleration, this one. Mass of block, a wedge into A. But what about this one? As this one moves left side with an acceleration, and this one moves right side, say it is going with an acceleration along this direction, along the inclined plane, it is A suffix R. Then along this direction will be cos, A suffix R cos, whatever angle is there, cos theta. Now, this block is going left side with an acceleration A, then what is the net acceleration available for this? That is A R cos theta minus A. I mean, you will get this type of expression. N sin theta will be the responsible force, A suffix R cos theta, which will play along this direction, because A suffix R is along this, and A suffix R cos theta will be along horizontal direction. minus whatever acceleration is taking place for the wedge, that has to minus from this into small m will be the now these two are equal in magnitude. Solving from here you can get your answer. Now see for this actual solution here. Now already you have shown that n sin theta is responsible force for small m, a suffix r cos theta minus a, for the big m also big m into a, these two will be equal, simplify, and this theta is 60 degrees, simplify from here, a suffix small r will come 2 times small m plus big m divided by small m into small a, this will come. Please check this. After simplification, let us a suffix r is the subject here, then a suffix r will come like this, twice small m plus big m divided by small m into a, that will c will be the answer for this. Now job number 14. There are two closed loop circuit is shown here, that is this one and this one, this one. Now we have to find out potential drop. What is the potential difference between the point A and D? From here to here we have to get potential drop. First you have to find out potential here, then you can find out drop, potential here as well as here. Let us find out potential here. Here, as it is a closed circuit, whatever current leaving the battery, same amount of current has to take part in inside. Same thing here, say I1 current passing through this and I2 current passing through this. Then we can easily find out potential here. Similarly here, let us see the solution. Here, you see in this route, total voltage is, battery source is 6 volt, total resistance 1, 2, 3, that means 2 plus 6 ohm, then current will be 1 ampere, 6 divided by 6, 1 ampere in this circuit. Now for the other one, 4 total is 8, no, 10, that means 0.4 ampere, sorry, 0.4 ampere. 0.4, 10, 4 divided by 10, that will give 0.4 ampere. Now these two currents are available. Now we are interested about potential here. How to get it? Supply is this one, 6 volt minus this drop. Here is 1, that means 2 volt drop will be there. So potential here will be how much? 4 volt. You can see here, 6 minus 2i. Now, sorry, potential at this point, similarly current is 0.4. 4 minus 6 in 2.4, then subtract this, you will get 1.6 volt here. Now between these two we are interested. Come, here you can see potential is VA, minus current is 1 ampere, so that means drop will be 3 volt, VA minus 3 volt, VA minus 3i, it will be 3 volt. Again, there is a battery opposite polarity here, the minus 5. That means you have started here, VA minus 3i is 1, that means 3 volt minus 5, where you are here. Then again a drop, because current in this direction, 6 into 2.4, that means your equation will be VA minus 3 minus 5 minus 2.4, it will come 2.4, then it is equal to VD, or keep current as it is, substitute later on. VA minus VD will be how much? 3i plus 6i2, 3i1 plus 6i2 plus 5 in the other side of the equal sign. So put 1, then 0.4, then plus 5, that will give you 10.4 volt. And C will be the answer. You can see here, C has 10. We got VA minus VD, potential drop. Next job is 15. Two elastic wave moves along the same direction in the same medium. The pressure amplitudes of both the waves are equal, but the wavelength of the first wave is 3 times that of the second. If the average power transmitted through unit area by the first wave is W1, power transmitted through unit area by the first wave is W1 and then by the second is W2. We have to see the relation between W1 and W2. Let us see. Here, power we can express in terms of this expression, that is half pressure amplitude square V into S by magnetic field. Now, sorry, bulk modulus. This B is bulk modulus here. Now, from here, and we can say that V is a function of this one. I mean, bulk modulus divided by density, root under bulk modulus divided by density. It is independent of frequency, independent of wavelength. Now, power is independent of wavelength. From this expression, it is clearly understood that power is independent of wavelength. Here, in the question, it is given both the wave travels in the same medium with same direction and with same pressure amplitude. So, what will happen? That power will remain same because it is same medium, pressure amplitude is same, it is given in the question. Velocity will be same, it is in same medium, area of cross section will be same as it is taken, same definition. So, bulk modulus of the medium is fixed because it is same medium. So, W1 will be equal to W2. Now, come to next job, that is, two positive charges of magnitude small q are placed at the ends of the side of a square of side twice a. Two negative charges of the same magnitude are kept at the corners. Starting from rest, if the charge capital Q, if the charge capital Q from the middle of side 1 to the center of the square, its kinetic energy at the center of the square will be. This is a simple job. Find out potential here. Find out potential here where it was initially. Then it will come with velocity here. Change in potential will give gain in kinetic energy. Potential, you know, simply because the radius, the distance of the side is twice a. Now, as it is middle position, so Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, capital Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught within bracket twice Q, because this scalar quantity, this one divided by A plus this one divided by A, minus this one into divided by this distance, similarly for this, so two times of that distance, that distance is root 5A. Now, from here, you can get the expression kinetic energy will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught twice QA by A within bracket, and that is 1 minus 1 by root under 5. A will be the answer here. Next question, that is, two plane mirrors are inclined at an angle theta as shown in the figure. If a ray parallel to OB strikes the mirror at P, and finally energy emerges parallel to this one, I mean it will, after reflection it will fall on OB, then it will move parallel to OA. That is the point. There are four choices. We have to see the correct one. Now here you can see this diagram. This ray will fall here, then reflection, then now you can say as angle of incidence and angle of reflection are equal, this is parallel after emerging out. That means this is theta, then this will be theta, then again this one theta, this angle x, this is x, x plus theta is 90, and another is theta plus alpha, this is alpha, theta plus alpha is 180, theta plus alpha will be 180, and x plus theta will be 90. Now from x you can substitute here, you can get alpha equal to twice theta, you will get this expression. This is 90 minus theta, this angle is 90 minus theta, x is how much, 90 minus theta, substitute here, you will get alpha equal to twice theta, that means thrice theta will be 180, thrice theta because twice x is nothing but thrice theta is coming. You see, substitute this one here, you can see alpha equal to twice theta. Then thrice theta is 180, that means theta will be 60 degree. That means this angle is 60 degree, that is our interest. Now come to next job, this is a simple one. Now come to this job 18. Two radioactive nuclei P and Q in a given sample decay into a stable nucleus R. Stable nucleus R, mind it. At time t equal to 0, number of P spaces are 4N0 and Q are N0 only. Half life P is 1 minute, whereas for Q it is 2 minutes. Initially, there are no nuclei of R present in the sample. When number of nuclei of P and Q are equal, this is important point, the number of nuclei of R